Hi there, it's Susan Adams again with Artfire Link, and I've got another tutorial for you on how to use the themer for your Artfire Studio. This will control not just the colors, but the format and layout of your store. It also controls your shop sections. The old way was a little bit less heavy on our browsers and computers, but for a lot of different reasons they turned to the JavaScript version. And I'll show you what I mean by that. Now, if you have a hard time using the themer for whatever reason, try using Chrome and try updating your JavaScript on your computer. It's the JavaScript from Oracle. Don't download any other mirror sites that's not from Oracle. And when you do finalize that download, make sure that the McAfee scanner is not checked, because they try to slip that in there. It's their support. They have teamed up with McAfee just because they need a little bit of financial support since it's free. It's the reason that they offer it for free. So don't check that one, and make sure you don't download it. If by some chance you do download that, you can go to your control panel and into your add and remove programs and remove it if you happen to download that. Okay, so to change the format open up the themer in your shop on Artfire, you just need to scroll down to under the Find Me Online box, and you'll see, as long as you're signed into your site, you'll see the toggle themer right there, and it'll pop up. Windows 7 seems to do a good job with this. XP struggles a little bit. I know mine does. All right. So trying to get that to go away. All right. So this bar up here is the main nav color, and you'll see it highlight, or it's supposed to highlight. Oops, it's up here. There it is right there. Okay. You've got the heading font color, which is all of these headings you can choose from. Your seller nav bar is this one right here. And the text is this one right here. You can choose whatever contrasting color that you want to use, white or black. And then your banner background color, which is this right here. Okay? And you've got your merchandiser, which you can change to the different formats. You can do 3 wide, you can do 4 wide. You can show sections, or you could not show sections. You can merchandise your order and change things around. Oops. Let's go back. You can use your merchandiser order, which is available through the back end in admin. And you can activate the merchandiser if you'd like. There you go. You can do it from the front end and move, drag, and drop stuff. The studio merchandiser. This is from page 1 to page 2. You see how that works? And it moves things around. All right. You can upload a new banner from here, or from the widget here, this little gear, or upload a new avatar here, or use, once the merchandiser is closed, you can use the gear that shows up right there. Fonts you can change. Let's close that. There we go. The fonts you can change to whatever font that you like. These are Google web fonts, so that they usually show up no matter what computer you're on, but they're very select. Alright, you can hide that themer, making it squish down, and then you have to save your theme. Alright, that's really pretty much how it goes. Now, for shop sections, you can add a new one here, or you can move them around Okay, or you can edit them. Okay, done. Trash. All right. And it's really as simple as that. And then turn off your theme. That should be pretty simple, pretty easy. If you have any more questions or you need to contact us for another tutorial, make a request at service@artfirelink.com. That's service@artfirelink.com. Please remember to leave me a great rating on our YouTube channel, and we'll see you next time.